Everybody, greetings and good tidings one and all, how goes it? I'm feeling rather talkative today, so this might run a little long, but that's okay because it's update time yet again. So settle in, let's start this thing off with The Hunted. Be careful what you hunt. This is on DVD thanks to E1 Entertainment. It was made in 2013, written by, starring, and directed by Josh Stewart. This is his first time in the directing chair, but he certainly worked with some notable Hollywood entities, and it seems like he learned a fair amount from them because this does not suck, alright? It's a found footage movie done with actors who can act, editors who can edit, sound guys who, you know, you get the idea, right? It's a capable bunch of people making this movie. So, two friends. One, a dedicated hunter and family man. The other, an ex-camera guy for an investigative news program. All right, you get it. They go out into the woods to put together a pilot for a hunting show. They have connections, they have a chance, they've got the opportunity, but they've also got problems, man. I mean, serious problems. It's a three-day trip to capture footage of a big buck that they call Movie Star. All right. And they call him that because you only ever see him in pictures. So that's the original goal. Anyway. And there's the disc. Of course, weird little things start to happen almost immediately. Let's call them warnings. Alright. Let's call them ignored warnings. And that's why we have a movie. And so by the time we get to the end of the third day, whoever or whatever it is that doesn't want them around has had enough of them being around. And as these things do, the final reels, or digital equivalent, I suppose, get fairly wild. All right, and there it is. A very fine movie. It's creepy, but it's put together professionally. It's a very potent atmosphere. Cover aside, no actual hunting takes place, or no successful hunting takes place. They don't really get the chance. So, yeah, I mean, since whatever is up their business ruins their efforts, they don't, if you're worried about that kind of stuff in this movie, there's none, all right? It's a solid movie, and I do recommend checking it out. It was a good time, and I have no actual complaints. I'm not saying it's the best one ever, but I've got no complaints about this movie. A disc has the trailer, thank you very freaking much, a commentary, and a little featurette with him that details the story, bridging the movie to the based on actual events claim at the top of the film. All right, I recommend checking that out as well. And there you have it. Make sure if you go out in the distant woods, you are in fact the hunter and not the hunted. It's Gangsters, Guns, and Zombies on DVD from Accelerator as part of their Macabre line. There is no US Blu-ray, as far as I know, and if you want it with a slipcover, that is an option, alright? But this option was under $2, and I'm, you know, I enjoy being a frugal sort of guy, so yeah, this is what I have. So, this you could look at as a sort of poorer cousin of Cockneys vs. Zombies, all right, because they were made around the same time, which, for reference, I absolutely love. I love Cockneys vs. Zombies. I think it's great. Here, the movie opens with bank robbers making their escape while the zombie apocalypse unleashes around them, all right? They got the money, got a brand new getaway driver who's the central character, for the record, and they've got an injured member who was shot in the stomach during their getaway. The idea is to make it to the safe house by way of the hospital and lay low. They do not get there, all right? it's a road movie, okay? And it's set up in a way where there are essentially themed events in the movie as it goes on. They are constantly sidetracked and diverted. So there's a bunch of those events. They stop at a hospital. You get you know, doctor and nurse zombies, right? They stop at a gas station and the local baseball team comes at them as zombies, etc. I mean, you get clowns and bridal parties and medieval fair reenactors. It's a lot of stuff like that. It's a blast. It's a lot of fun. Very creative with what they did with all that. Now, it does run a touch long in my humble estimation, and some tightening would have served the movie very well, I think. But I liked it. All right, it's as cheap as a coffee or less, and I'm happy to give it, say, I don't know, 3.5 out of 5. Just could have used a little tightening. Suffered from a little sameness after a while, but it still had more movie to go. I know they had to do things a certain way, but it's just my feeling. It's violent, it's very bloody, but it's not excessively gory in terms of, you know, limbs and innards and parts and all like that. All right, lots of blood splatter though. There are a couple effects at the beginning, I guess, as grabbers. I have no real problem with any of that, by the way. It's not a complaint, just thought it might be important to point that out. So yeah, I guess this geezer I'll be putting on the shelf, innit? This is the Shadow Man, all right? The truth of it, I thought this was something else altogether. I saw the menu, and there was just this aggressively annoying, folksy, almost hymnal-like song playing over this picture, and I thought, huh, maybe I made a mistake here. I pushed play, and that abysmal song kicked in again over the first scene, and I was like, yeah, I definitely made a mistake. I'm not completely sure what I have this confused with, or had it confused with. Maybe the Bye Bye Man, maybe the Slender Man. I'm just not sure. I want to see both of those, by the way. I haven't. And I'm pretty sure I got one of those jumbled up with this thing. Okay. I thought, all right, let's give it a shot. And then it was only 12 minutes in when I started checking the timer. Just to see how far it was, all right? 12 minutes. Woof. I thought it was a half hour in, all right? This thing, okay, quickly, I'm going to give you the plot. This is about a depressed, addicted, injured, out of work, semi-alcoholic, totally closed off iceberg of a woman named Rachel, okay, who's in a bad marriage with an unfaithful husband who, for the record, later tries to rape her while he's drunk, which was kind of shocking since he had all the personality, depth, and charisma of a freaking used ketchup packet up to that point. Worthless. Anyway, yeah, Rachel occasionally sees a black ghostly figure in a hat in the first part of the story. Then, for nearly an hour and a half, people freaking talk about that, okay? At the end, there's a smattering of last-minute sloppy gore, and it's finally over, except for having to endure that brain-bludgeoning piece of crap song yet another time. Because hearing it, like, all those times through the movie, that wasn't enough, right? That's it. That's it. That's this movie, all right? I didn't like it. I was bored by it. I was a little bit confused by it. It was an absolute struggle to get through, which I decided around the halfway point I would do so that I could show it in this video, because that was the only value I was going to get from this dull, convoluted waste of my afternoon. All right? The acting slipped back and forth between barely acceptable at its best and much less acceptable, while the story became ever more unclear as it dragged on and on and on and on. All right, I'm not showing any pictures for this one because I like you people. You are my friends, and that would make me an irresponsible updater. All right, I despise this movie. It has agitated me so much that for the first time since I'm back, that's right. Made me feel much, much better. Now, night shift. See the shift in tone in my voice there? That's the shift. Night Shift. This is a Irish horror movie. It was released in 2018. This one had some tough reviews. I was aware of it already, and it had some tough reviews. I was very hesitant about it. It's got the generic name and all that. But, you know, it's hard to resist inexpensive horror movies that you haven't seen, right? You guys know where I'm coming from. And finding things like this at its price point at the time, that's one of the reasons. Very difficult to resist. So, in this one, a girl's going to school in Ireland, and she's looking for some extra money. She gets a job at a hotel at reception on the night shift, right? This is rough because, again, her school means she's doomed to be tired at all times. And on top of that, she's afraid of the dark. So, yeah. The hotel has plenty of dark areas, being a hotel at night. She's intent on pushing through because, again, she really needs the extra cash. Don't we all? So, I don't know much to say here. She finds out fairly quickly that the hotel had been closed for years due to a bloody massacre that had taken place there. The climactic moments of which are the start of the movie. You see him at the beginning of the film. She was having a bad first night anyway, all right? But after she finds out the place's history, she begins to have a much worse one, okay? Strange visions, weird guests, things pile up and as it goes on. Same as the slip there. All right, and it's revealed that this is tough. It's revealed that this is a ghost story, okay? Sort of a ghost story, kind of. And the skin mask wearing, Freako, that was on the front cover, and you saw him a little bit on the back there. Yeah, he might not be done yet, all right? He's the guy who responsible for the earlier massacre and starts making his appearances. So this is pretty cool to me, okay? Not brand new in any way, but cool nonetheless. It's a slow burn suspenser a lot of the time, and I enjoyed that a lot. Had a couple of standout scenes which mattered and just looked fantastic. You'll know them when you see them. It's definitely a weird one with characters not understanding their collective roles, I guess, as history is forced to play itself out once again as part of some dark ritual that was begun a long time ago. But I'm going to stop there. I don't want to get too specific. I liked it. It says that it contains, I believe the words, yeah, no focus, okay. Extreme violence and disturbing content, and that's true. But it isn't a gore fest. It's bloody, it's violent, it's actually a bit mean at times, but it's not gore, like limbs or hearts or anything like that, mostly. A little bit, but mostly not. Heavy on the thick atmosphere and stressful. Just stressful suspense, like I said, but not a gore fest by any stretch. It's a mood piece. I enjoyed it quite a bit more than I thought I would, more than I was expecting to. And I guess it goes with things like, I mean, Innkeepers jumps immediately to mind, but cross that with something like Last Shift, put those together, and I guess that's a little bit close. It's not as great as either of those, in my opinion. I love both those movies, but it's solid and it's entertaining on its own. Maybe it even has a little bit of Bloody New Year in it, a little bit, Norman J. Warren's movie. Just in that neighborhood, anyway. As those and others like them have... Man, I just can't say too much. It's all spoilers. So Night Shift. Good times. Weird mind screw horror movie. Well acted. Confidently presented. It gets the recommendation from me, all right? Just remember... Never ask what the extra towels are for when you're working the night shift. Okay, how about Alpha Alert? It's a lesser-known movie from 2013. It's released by Lionsgate. I keep wanting to call it Alpha Protocol. Any other gamers out there? Anyway, it's Alpha Alert. Okay, let's do the plot. We'll do the plot first. Three different soldiers, all from Washington, D.C., all suffering from extreme post-traumatic stress disorder from pretty severe combat situations. They end up leaving the medical building they're in all at the same time by elevator. As they're going down, the elevator shakes, kind of almost rattles. They get stuck. They don't know why at first, but soon learn through the emergency talk box and the news that they get on their phones that DC has been attacked. Terrorists have set off bombs, and in at least one case, it's a radioactive dirty bomb. The cloud from said bomb is heading towards their building, which is being evacuated. So, yeah, I would call that a stressful situation. And I don't know how much further to take the description. I kind of want to go a little further because the front cover there at the bottom sort of says what I'm thinking about avoiding. But, all right, let's put it like this. There's a major story shift around 40 minutes in, all right? After that shift takes place, there's still over half a movie left, for things to go from bad to significantly worse. And I'll just leave it like that. That's pretty good. This is a great movie. All right, it's absorbing, it's suspenseful, it's paranoid, it's tense, completely just, it's screwed up. It's screwed up. It's screwed up AF. All right. And there's conspiracy, and there's a point you can carry away with you as well, but it's not one of those movies that, hammers you down with some social, political ideology or anything that one person wants to get across to you. It's not like that, so don't worry about that. Like all the best examples of this kind of movie, it's an entertainment first. That's what it's concerned with. What else you get out of it varies based on who you are. So, yeah, great. And yes, a large portion of this lower budget movie does, in fact, take place in an elevator. This is not a bad thing. It's claustrophobic. It raises the tension. And yeah, there's nothing wrong with it. It did a good job. It's recommended. I liked it quite a bit. Now, fun fact, nothing in this update was over $8. This one here, at just a little bit under $8, was the most expensive purchase out of everything. One of them, the now flushed disc that is no longer a threat to you or the people you care about most, that garbage was a buck. The rest were all in between. I built this update that way on purpose because I ordered Alpha Alert, was real happy with the price drop, and I thought about all the deals I've lucked upon as of late. So I thought this would be a cool way to show some things, just make an update out of it. So if you're interested in any of these four movies, or even that other whatever, you can grab yourself a movie or two without breaking the bank. All right. That's just my quiet, humble response to all the high-priced box set mania that we've all been experiencing as of late. It's nice to get a break from that once in a while. There's other stuff out there, some good stuff out there, and a lot of it's very cheap. It can be had rather inexpensively and with very little effort, like this hidden gem right here, Alpha Alert. So, miraculously, somehow, I don't know how, I managed to do this 4 weeks in a row, four updates in a row. Over 4 weeks. I'm thinking you probably would have bet against it, right? Yeah, me too. Still, here we are, and as great as that has been, it had to come to an end at some point, and that's where we are. Nothing dramatic or anything, just with Christmas and all that, I think that'll be about all until either the following week, which is just a few days after Christmas and a few days before New Year, so maybe the first week of January. I don't know. I wasn't planning. I thought I'd be gone 1 week. You know what? I think Stay away for 2 weeks. Just let all the festive days roll comfortably on by, you know? I have to figure everybody will be pretty busy and there'll be a lot of other more important things to get done and pay attention to, right? Yeah. Okay, so let's do that. I'll be back in the first week of January. So I guess happy holidays. And I'm sure I'll be watching plenty between now and then. So the bright side of that is that I should be able to cherry pick some pretty cool things to show by then. Okay. So yeah, happy holidays, happy new year. And I can tell you I've never meant that more than I mean it right now. Happy New Year. And until then, take care of yourselves, stay safe, and I will catch you later.